डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द पासवर्ड क्रैकिंग टूल्स ऑफ, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन अर्लियर सेशन, जॉन द रीपर एंड टूल्स रिगार्डिंग पासवर्ड क्रैकिंग। नाउ these are the actually outline for the today's session: learning objective, introduction, password cracking and brute force tools, John the Ripper, PHT crack, password dump, THC Hydra. As we have discussed John the Ripper tool in our previous lecture, now these are the learning objectives. After studying this unit, student should be able to crack the password using tools and penetrate into the system, and also you are able to use the various brute force tools for the password cracking. So basically this block is focused to discuss password and user account exploitation is one of the largest issue in network security. In this section, we will look at password cracking, how and why of it. We will look at just how easy it is to penetrate a network, how attackers get in, the tools they use, and ways to combat it. Now, PHT crack, L0 PHT crack is known as best Windows password auditing tool. Through that can be used by network or system administrator for auditing weak password, and can also help a hacker to recover the password from password hashes. As we know that Windows stored the user account password in SAM file or system file in Windows System 32 or system folder. So it is best suitable tool for the Windows password auditing, and many system administrator or cracker or pen tester, they are using such kind of tool to crack the password or recover the password hashes. So how to install it? L0 PHT crack 7 is the latest version in current scenario, is distributed in a self-installing executable distribution file that can be downloaded for free at mentioned website l0phtcrack.com download html. So through that you are able to get the exe file or PHT crack tool, and there are several steps to perform to install this PHT crack tool. So you have to provide the steps, you have to perform the steps to install this PHT crack by clicking on next, next, and at last you have to perform OK to install this PHT crack. By installing when you are performing the first time executing this PHT crack. So this is the welcome screen in PHT crack. Inside this PHT crack, there are several steps like password auditing wizard, start a new session, open an existing session, and you can see there is a recent session inside this window. So this is the very first screen whenever the PHT crack has been executed. So wizard overview. Basically, the PHT crack 7 wizard help you to quickly configure the setting needed to retrieve and audit password by the most common means, and provides a quick overview of the password auditing process. So how to import password hashes in PHT crack software? PHT crack 7 can import password hashes. Generally, the password is stored in hashes. That means it is in encrypted form. Windows never stored a password in plain text. It is always in encrypted form, or we can say it is stored in SAM, that is Security Account Manager file, in Windows especially. So PHT crack 7 can import password hashes directly from remote machine, from the local file system, from the SAM file for the Windows, pwdump, that is password dump, or shadow file, which is for Linux, and from Active Directory, the PHT crack can get the password hashes. Obtaining password over the network require network access and administrative privileges to the target machine. Without that, remotely PHT crack cannot reveal the password hashes. To begin the import process, you must have to select the import from the password menu sidebar on the left hand side of the main screen. So there are several steps to perform the import password hashes. When import is selected, you will see the main window display and the import mechanism. When you select an import mechanism, you will see the right side of the main window change to a dialog for the input requires, such as file and machine names. So inside we must have to provide the machine names, or we have to select that particular machine or targeted machine which you want to crack for that particular password. Next step for the import password hashes is to input the required file names, host name, and options for an import mechanism, which is must be required to import the password hashes. So you will see the action buttons: run, import immediately, and add import to queue. Okay, so these are the various buttons available and it became active. After providing file name, host name, and various required options. Otherwise, it will be in disable form, or we can say it's in gray form. It is in inactive mode. So we must have to provide search required files and hostname options. At this point, you will likely press run import immediately to perform the import action. After that button is active, you can press run import immediately. Then after, your password hashes has been imported. Now, how can import from local machine? To import password hashes from local machine, you must be login with administrator privileges or rights, or have an administrator password pair. Otherwise, you are not able to get the hashes or from the local machine. So, the local machine import works regardless of whether password are stored in same file or in an active directory. So, same file, as discussed earlier, same file is secured account manager, which stores the password of the Windows account machine, especially used for Windows operating system. Also, the password is stored in Active Directory also. So, whenever Windows machine stored any kind of password or system password actually, they are stored in same file which is located at C drive, Windows, System 32 or System 64, system file actually. And from there, the password can be get for the local machine. So, how can we perform such kind of operation in phtcrack tool? First, select the import from local Windows system option while you are performing the phtcrack session. You can select to keep currently imported accounts. If you are adding this import to accounts hashes you have already imported, that means if you have already performed such kind of operation and again you would like to import, then session can continue or that particular account can be added for import to account hashes which are already imported. If this option is not selected, then you must be import will overwrite any previously imported account. If you want to audit all system accounts, not just user accounts, you can select to include machine accounts. Means you are not providing specific system account, you are getting the whole account which are available in my particular local system. So, you are able to get the entire system account's password. So, for that you have to select to include machine accounts. Now, from the remote machine, how can we import? So, in phtcrack, there is a facility or option, we can say, to import from remote machine. To import from the remote machine, select either import from Linux, BSD, Solaris, AIX system, or SSH if your target system is Unix-like. means if your remote machine having a Unix kind of operating system or Linux, BSD, Solaris, then you have to go for that particular option. If you are using Windows system, then at the same time you have to select import from remote Windows system. That means the targeted remote machine have the operating system from the Windows family. Again, you must have the credential with root or admin administrator privileges as are required. So through the remote machine option, you are able to fetch that particular password file. If a security tool or some other element in the network environment is preventing remote hash retrieval, then you may have to use a third-party tool to obtain the hashes and then follow the instruction for importing hashes from a password dump file, PW dump file, or SAM file, system file for the Windows, or shadow file for the Unix. PW dump. Next password cracking and brute force tool is password dump, PW dump. The original PW dump, password dump, we can say, the original password dump program was written by Jeremy Allison in 1997 to demonstrate how to extract password hashes from the Windows registry. As we know that many system configuration files are stored in Windows registry, and you can execute this Windows registry by entering the command in run window of the Windows operating system. You have to reg edit, then you will get the Windows registry. So there are so many registry inside the Windows registry file, HKLM, like hardware, software, and all kinds of registry will be there. Since then, other developers have created many versions of password dump to keep up with various updates to Windows. But they all rely on extracting hashes from the registry as well as SAM file or elsas.exe process memory space. So password dump basically relies from these many kinds of files in Windows operating system. The elsas, actually it's a service exe. elsas.exe is the process handles the local security subsystem service. It's a local security subsystem service. It's essentially responsible for the authentication, which is why it is memory contained the system's password hashes. elsas.exe is continuously executed in background, or we can say it's in daemon, because it is a service. So from this elsas.exe, password dump will fetch the password hashes. So how to download or execute this password dump utility tool? Actually, there is a URL, as I mentioned in the screen, www.openvault.com/password/microsoft windows nt 2000 xp 2003 vista 7. It might be changed in current scenario, but you may found this password dump utility from openvault.com/passwords, and there are so many other utilities also available in this particular website. So how to use this password dump? They require actually admin privileges. That's why you have to run the terminal, or we can say a command prompt shell with run as admin privileges. You are not going to suppose execute the CMD directly. You must have to execute this CMD or command prompt with run as admin privileges by right click on this command exe file. So you will get the admin privilege for that particular command shell. The following example demonstrate password dump 6 version on a 64-bit Windows system. So as mentioned in this block, here you can see the password dump 6 is the actually file folder name which have password dump.exe file. By providing this command, you will get the account detail like administrator or user or guest user. So you have to enter such kind of command for the localhost: password dump.exe -n -x localhost. Then after, THC Hydra, also known as Hydra. So Hydra is the tool for the brute password cracking or brute force tools, we can say. THC Hydra easily surpasses the majority of brute force tools available on the internet for two reasons. It is fast and it targets authentication mechanism for several dozen protocols. So actually in the market or over the website, over the internet, you will get so many tools for password cracking. Among them, here we have discussed some of the tools or introduced some of the tools. Among them, Hydra is the brute force tools which is fast in the execution. So Aircrack NG is again a one tool which is provide the facility for cracking the password or getting the password of the Wi-Fi. So through that software you are able to get the password of specific Wi-Fi in your range. So it has some steps to perform the aircrack NG operation. But it is available in Linux as well as in Windows also. So don't rely only such kind of tools. There are so many tools for the password cracking. Among them, we are going to discuss, or we have discussed, such software tools. So THC Hydra can get or download it from mentioned URL, that is www.thc.org/THC Hydra, and you will get the latest Hydra project for password cracking. How to install? Basically, the Kali Linux has the pre-installed in the Hydra is already installed. For other Linux operating system, you may download from the repository by using sudo command sudo apt-get install Hydra. So through that you are able to install the Hydra tool. Hydra GTK is the GUI front-end version for the Linux. Okay, so if you are running Kali Linux, this will already be pre-installed for everyone. When we open Hydra, we are getting this help screen. By observing this, you will be able to get the just idea regarding the Hydra. There are several parameter, dash L for the user, dash L user list is provided, dash C for the default TXT is there. Through that you are perform the password cracking operation. The username can be single username such as admin, or username list, password list is usually any text file that contains potential password, and target can be an IP address and port, or it can be a specific web form field. So as mentioned in the screen, you will see that Hydra dash L provide the username, dash P provide the password file list, and provide the target. So target can be IP address or port or specific web. Through that you are able to fetch the password. And how to use this? You are performing such kind of command and you will get the password. So in this example, you can see I am using Hydra to try to crack the admin password using the rockyou.txt file is my word list file, which is situated and a targeting host, targeting IP is here, you can see 192.168.89.190 on specific port, that is 80. So here you can see the example or command in mentioned screen. I would like to conclude over here for this particular session. Thank you very much. Swadhyaya.